ABC's political director and moderator of Meet the Press. Chuck, good morning. Monica laid it out very well. The White House feels good about the week it just had, closing the book on the midterms with that win in Georgia, passing marriage equality through Congress, obviously getting Brittany Griner home, gas prices ticking down. But President Biden remains underwater in the polls. Inflation is still high. What position is he in as he contemplates this decision about 2024?
Well, look, I think he's in an extraordinarily good position inside the Democratic Party and in sort of Washington. But what is fascinating to see is, and I think, frankly, I think the Kyrsten Sinema party switch puts an almost an exclamation point on this, is that the midterms were not about the Democrats. And voters didn't sit here to say reward Democrats. They repudiated Trump Republicans. And so the good news for Biden is that I think his MAGA Republican message, which there was some dispute and debate inside the party whether that was the right thing to lean into, turned out to be the right thing to lead into. It was a winning message to win over independents. And so that's the good news for him, which is why I think the Democratic capital he's gotten is quite significant. And that's why you're not hearing about whispers of primary challenges or anything like that. But I do think it's a reality check here. It hasn't budged his numbers. Now, let's see if the first of the year he gets a little bit of a bump if all this lame, you know, as people process everything that is happening over the last couple of weeks, Brittany Griner home, you know, marriage equality codified into law. You know, ask me again in 3 weeks. But it does seem as if he's certainly better positioned inside the party. The question is whether the general public is there.
You're right. The Republicans have a lot to work out on their side of the 2024 race as well. Chuck, thanks so much. We'll look for much more this morning on Meet the Press when Chuck is joined by Democratic Senator John Tester of Montana and former U.S. Attorney Preet Bharara.